Welcome back, geology fans. When we left off last time, we were at the top of the amphitheater at Red Rocks Park. Here, differential erosion exposes layers of rock to our east as linear ridges and valleys, while great mountains stand above us to the west. We can really get a good big-picture view here. So the mountains are still the elephant in the room. Last week on campus, we saw tilted rocks, and here you see tilted rocks, and the same Rocky Mountain uplift tilted them. The layers we see suggest beds of sedimentary rocks in the amphitheater. Besides original horizontality being broken, we know from lateral continuity that these layered rocks used to continue to the west, but were removed in this area. We also know these layers continue into the ground, and from drilling around Denver, we know that these same red rocks we see here are underneath the city as well. An obvious question here is up direction. Or are these layers overturned? We need to know this to use the law of superposition to properly order the record. From what we saw on campus, overturned rock dips to the west, so it seems unlikely these east-dipping rocks are upside down, but we can check on the way to our first site. All you tremendously invested and observant students will see cross-bedding, and gasp in excitement as you confirm your suspicion of sedimentary layers and gain sacred knowledge of the ancient flow direction and the up direction, which says these rocks are not overturned. They're just very tilted. So, as on campus, older rocks will be to the west, and younger rocks will be to the east. And so we will continue walking as far to the west as we're committed to find the oldest contact in our local geologic story.